These are unique two-wheeled handmade bicycles made of wood. They're commonly known in the East African region as chukudus. Well, people from Goma understand this well. One can simply call them wooden bikes or wooden scooters. They have no engine, no pedals. All you do is simply roll down the hill. Everyone riding enjoys this, but when climbing, due to no engine, you also have to push it. But this is more than a wooden bicycle in this region. It's rather a way of life. These chukudus are a huge part of the economy. A chukudu can carry goods and people from one place to another, and many people use these wooden bicycles when delivering goods, hence earning some money. This young boy, Pascal, studied far away from school and later decided to drop out after covering 12 kilometers every morning and every evening. The journey was too long for the boy to cover by foot. But after making this wooden bicycle, life is good. He's now going to school and dreaming big. He wants to become a mayor. Apart from this, a chukudu can entertain people as children in this area always make a competition, racing to see who comes first. But finishing the race, is another story. This whole region is known for two things. One, big mountains, and two, wooden scooters. This is a day in life with a wooden scooter. Claude did not have enough funds to buy a bicycle. He thought of making this scooter a few years ago, and now the scooter has changed his life. He wakes up every morning and goes to the market, then starts delivering goods to different people. Claude has been doing this for the past 5 years, and this job has helped the man to raise her children and pay their school fees. In other words, he's self-reliant. The idea came as he could see he had no job, yet he had to find any possible way and feed the family. He then decided to make this chukudu. He made it by himself, and the rest is now history. At first, he never thought that such a wooden bike would be productive, as most times only children were using it for fun, just riding. And as an old person, he could not use it for mere riding. He says it requires a lot of energy as it has no brakes, no engine, no shock absorbers. He has to put his life on the line all for the sake of providing for his children. As they say, the heart of a father is the masterpiece of nature. His love might be unexpressed, but his care and protection remains a pillar of strength to the family.
Pascal.
12-year-old Pascal studies in primary too. The school is located very far from home. He says it takes a journey of more than 12 kilometers. This forced the young boy to drop out of school, and he could see his dreams are not coming true. But then he gradually learned how he can make himself a wooden bike. It took him 2 weeks, 2 days, and 7 hours to make this wooden scooter, also known as a chukudu. The mother tells us more of her boy.
Naje kujya gutangiza umwana yari afite imyaka itandatu. Ubwo umwana yize igihembwe kimwe ahita avamo.
Pascal did not enjoy school at first, all because of a long journey of 12 kilometers he had to cover each morning and every evening on foot, all for striving for a better chance of tomorrow, until he told his mother that he will never go back to school. After a few days, the mother started seeing him cut trees down and start from scratch in making this wooden scooter. And by when it was complete, the boy asked his mother to register him in class again. All he does is waking up, wash himself, get ready for school, then ride his chikudu, and off he goes to school. This prevents him from coming late at school, and his teachers are always proud of him. He says he's keen on learning. He has the courage and zeal so that he would become a helpful member in the family. His dream is to become a mayor, and he's doing everything possible to make his dreams come true. In this region, they are never short of entertainment, and they have a unique racing that combines bravery with incredible artistry. Every summer, villagers gather to watch a race unlike any other, flying down the region's steep hills at speeds that reach at 30 meters per hour. These young riders challenge each other with handcrafted wooden scooters. These beautifully crafted bikes don't have brakes, so riders must rely on their skills to avoid crashing. This is one of the most peculiar races you'll see today, as it never comes to an end. Ever since it started 7 years ago, no one has ever came out as a winner. Among different people who come to watch this race, parents are always there to support their children, and they're so proud of their children. She says the competition is tough, and children do this as having fun rather than competition, which makes it interesting. But say, if they had sponsors who'd come and invest in these, children then would do this as a profession, not just for the sake of having fun. Emmanuel is one of the competitors in this race, and he is always one of the favorites to win the race. But the competition is too difficult and at the same time too dangerous to win. What is interesting about all who compete in this race is that they are the ones who make their own bikes, and Emmanuel shows us how he can assemble all these wooden materials. First, you have to gather woods, then look for a sharp machete, then start assembling these woods until you make a complete wooden bike. For wheels, it takes something special for them to be smooth and enable movement easily. They have to apply cooking oil, and this cooking oil always causes some big problems between parents and their children, as most children steal this cooking oil from parents. And at the end of the day, the wooden bike is complete and ready to compete. Emmanuel says one of the main reasons the competition is difficult to win, there are no infrastructures, just poor roads. The competition starts well when everyone is ready and eager to win. But it's difficult riding these chikudus, as none of them have neither pedals nor engine. It never comes to an end, but well, the intention is always having fun. The mother to Emmanuel says the competition would be better if they had some sponsors and every competitor would fight until the end, hence making the competition more difficult and more interesting for spectators like her and many others. As the competition never comes to an end, the finish line always has a few people who also know that it's difficult for one to reach there. If these riders start crashing with each other, then they all start lifting their chikudus and leave the competition, as none of them is ever wearing protective equipment. It takes concentration and a steady hand to safely ride this wooden scooter down a hill. These scooters have helped many people around here, as whether in taking people to different places, or whether transporting goods from one place to another, or just as simply as a way of entertainment. For those who can't afford bicycles and more advanced means of transport, they go for chikudus. And if you own one of these, you surely will overcome one of the daily challenges here in this life. Thanks for watching. Please give a like if you enjoyed the video and remember to subscribe.